with me, your beauty queen V Cada, Kiara Gregorio on BRGY. Ang last guest natin ay isang influencer turned actress na ngayon minamahal gabi-gabi sa FPJ's Batang Quiapo as Camille. How did Yuki Takahashi change her career path? At bukod sa acting, saan pa nga ba siya unang napansin? Yuki Takahashi graces our last Best of Saucy.
Hi Yuki! Thank you so much for joining us here at BRGY. You could say hello to all of our B-fam watching.
Hi B-fam! Thank you so much for inviting me here.
Yes.
Dahil at finally na-meet na kita in person.
Yes, so, yeah. If you guys know, well, I've seen Yuki a lot since her TikTok days. I've been seeing her on our For You page. But then we were on Batang Quiapo at the same time,
yeah.
But at the same time, we never actually met
we
each other.
We never actually met each other.
Yeah, kaya it's very, very exciting to finally meet you. But of course, I want to go dive right into you because this episode is all about you. Our B-fan wants to know all about you. But you actually come from a family who love to sing. But apparently, unlike them, you wanted to go more the actress route.
Yeah.
And you wanted to go more about the acting or dancing even way. So can you tell us more about that?
It was really my dream since when I was young to be an actress, but parang hindi talaga siya pinagtagpo during that time. And I feel like the pandemic is a blessing in disguise for me. Kasi doon nangyari lahat, doon ako nag-start. And with the dancing kasi, it's parang I feel like it's really my passion. But there was never an action to do that passion.
You also auditioned for different TV roles and you've even auditioned for commercials. Mm-hmm. Pero lagi daw wrong timing. It was never the right time for you to get the roles for those. So, I mean, para sa'yo, what was the main reason? Like, do you feel that maybe back then you weren't ready? Or ano ba kaya yung reason kung bakit ngayon it was the perfect time?
Maybe that time, I think it's not God's perfect timing. I feel like maybe that time, I'm not gonna be the person who I am today, like a stronger version of me, a wiser version of me.
But of course, here on BRGY, we like to keep things a bit lighter, a bit fun. So when we want to get to know you, we're gonna talk about your career journey, syempre, but we're going to play a game. So ito naman, this game we're gonna call Guess the Job. So since this episode is about new career paths, you just have to guess the profession based on the emojis that we show on the screen. G.
Okay. G.
Okay, let's see. Let's have our first emoji.
Social media influencer or TikToker?
Yan! Yes! Ang galing mo talaga. But you actually talked to us, you actually said just earlier that the pandemic kind of came as a blessing in disguise.
Yeah.
That's when you downloaded TikTok and you actually went through your passion of dancing, ganyan. Pero syempre, it kind of took a while for people to accept TikTok.
Yeah.
There was a time na medyo may mga tao, they would judge you na parang, oh, do you have TikTok? Okay.
Yeah.
So what really made you parang say, okay, no. I'm gonna download TikTok. I'm gonna start dancing.
Dahil pandemic, wala na talaga akong magawa. Like, wala na talaga akong magawa. Lahat na ng pagkain na kain ko, lahat na ng mukbang na panood
yung
ko,
coffee.
All of it, tapos na. So parang, sige na nga, magda-download ako ng TikTok and then, just, wala lang, sayaw lang so I can learn new things habang naka-lockdown.
But, speaking of that, I mean, you now currently have over 9 million followers on TikTok. Grabe! Congratulations! That's very, very exciting. And to surf mo naman. Every single person there followed you for a reason. But you were even nominated back in 2022 as TikTok Celebrity of the Year. Grabe! Kaya ang haba ng hair niya, the girl. I love it. No, but how did you realize that, wait, yung pagte-TikTok ko, yung hobby ko, parang I can actually turn it into a job even, or I can turn it into something serious.
When I hit mga 5 million, kasi that's the time na brand starting parang
malapit na sa'yo.
So parang, ay, pwede pala, pwede kong pagkakitaan. So at least meron na akong trabaho and may pagkakaabalahan na ako during pandemic.
So yeah, okay, ito naman, let's have our second option here.
singer?
Yes, singer. Ang galing. Okay. So, like I said, you mentioned that your family, you come from a family of singers. Although you said that you were never 100% fully interested in singing, you did release a song. You released a song called Bounce. It's okay. We need to have our canon event. But I mean, how was that experience for you?
Inoffer lang siya sa akin within that day.
Oh.
And then they gave me the lyrics same day, and then they just made me read it for like a few minutes. Tapos sabi, mag-record ka na. So my initial reaction was like, seryoso kayo?
But after being able, obviously, to do both dancing and then to do singing, I mean, ikaw, do you have plans on continuing either one? Dancing, maybe you plan on pursuing that? Singing, are you hoping on maybe finding that perfect song?
I would want to pursue dancing first.
Dancing, yeah.
Dancing. Kasi it's been parang my passion ever since. Na walang ang action. So walang say-say yung passion nyo if you're not gonna put an action.
No,
so
that's
parang
true. Okay. Ito naman, let's see what's next on our list.
Host?
Yeah! Because actually, you host, diba sabi ko, when I introduced you, I said it. You know, if you're a part of the P-pop scene, you might have seen her host before. But you were a host, not only just for that, but for a TV variety show. And obviously, it's very exciting to do a variety show.
Yeah.
I feel like so much is happening all at the same time.
Yeah.
So can you tell us about your experience with that?
During that time, it was kind of hard, but I really enjoyed it so much.
But I mean, it's very, very exciting, syempre, to experience. One of the reasons why I would love hosting a show, see the journey from the beginning all the way to the end. So what was that like for you?
What I love about it is naging healthy competition siya. Like, they really helped each other to grow inside the campus. And their talents, their aura, yung charm nila, it changed so drastically. And then now I heard some of the groups meron na silang kanya-kanyang groups and they perform ngayon, so I'm really, really proud of you guys.
So it's so nice to see her transition from an influencer and now to becoming eventually an actress on our TV screens, diba? Ngayon, abangers na ang Batang Quiapo viewers kung kailan nga ba talaga manganganak ang character ni Yuki na si Camille. And recently, she also shared how playing the role of Camille taught her to love herself even more. Ano nga pa kaya ang bagong projects na gagawin ng internet personality na si Yuki? Abangan nating lahat yan by following her on her social media accounts. Grabe nakakatuwa yung episode natin ito, no? It really teaches us to bounce back and really begin again. And for me, my best way to bounce back is really just taking time out from that situation, taking time to rest and reflect on what had happened, and of course surrounding yourselves with people who could really help you thrive even more. So B-Fam, may mga na-miss ba kayong BRGY moment? Don't worry, you can always start watching them again. Simply go to ABS-CBN Entertainment YouTube channel on YouTube and search for BRGY. Not only that, mababalikan nyo rin kami sa iWantTFC app anytime, anywhere. Just download iWantTFC app via Google Play Store for Android users and Apple App Store for iPhone users. Or visit iWantTFC.com and watch your favorite Kapamilya shows for free. See you all next time. I am your beauty queen, B. Kada, Kiara Gregorio, here on The Place to Be. Be happy, be you, BRGY. Hola, hey, mabuhay.